गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद हाउ डू आवर एक्टिविटीज इफेक्ट द एनवायरनमेंट, मीन व्हाट टाइप ऑफ एक्टिविटीज वी डू जनरली दैट आर इफेक्टिंग द एनवायरनमेंट. सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग दैट, बट बिफोर वी स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक we will firstly recall whatever we had discussed on last turn. So on last turn we had discussed about ecosystem and its types that were natural and artificial. Beside that we had discussed about food chain, food web, and then trophic levels, etc. So trophic level, as we have discussed earlier, all these. So first of all, now I will start with trophic levels that we have discussed on the last turn. So various steps of the food chain through which transfer of energy takes place are called trophic levels. These are the levels or steps in a food chain in which transfer of food or energy take place from one organism to another. So trophic level is the steps or levels in a food chain in which transfer of food takes place from one organism to another. This is called as energy levels. So energy level, as we see, that it starts from producers, and these are first level, first trophic level. This is the first trophic level. So all producers, they are first level of, they occupy first level of trophic or first trophic level. These are greater in number, so individual in this level are greatest, or we can say plants are more than the other trophic levels. Then this place is occupied by herbivores. As you see, these are less in number than producers, and they occupy second trophic level. After that, this is the carnivores, and they occupied the third trophic level. And then top carnivore that occupied the fourth trophic level. So this is the trophic levels. While we study about the trophic level, we come to know that the food chain always starts from the producers. So we can say all flesh in the universe is grass, or as all meat eating animals or meat or flesh of the animals comes from the plants. After that we come to know, or we notice, that the size of animals at each of the trophic levels goes on increasing, mean size of the animal goes on increasing. Then all the animals and plants are conserved by the decomposers or parasites. So we can say the decomposer decompose all the plants and animals. So this is the food chain or trophic levels. Now we will talk about the food chain. Food chain, as we have seen here, it starts from the producer, then herbivore, then carnivore, and top carnivore are there. And it is always unidirectional. I mean, it starts always from the producers and ends to up to the carnivores or top carnivores. Then food web. It is a network of interconnecting food chain. As food chains do not operate in isolation. For example, plant matter may be eaten up by grasshopper, caterpillar. I mean, as we have discussed earlier, plants, they can be eaten by many of the organism of next level. They can be grasshoppers, then deer, then goat. So a food web always have interlinking food chains. Now we will talk about how do our activities affect the environment. So our activities, as we know, we human beings are the integral part of the environment, and the changes in environment affect us. I mean, when there is change in environment, we are affected by it. Besides that, our activities to bring changes in the environment. I mean, we ourselves are doing bad for the environment. Now, as we have studied in class 9th also, that our activity pollute the environment. We generate so much of waste that due to generation of more waste, we are facing two major problems. And these problems are needed to be resolved as soon as possible, as these could be the cause of global warming, means warming of our earth, or increase in temperature. Besides that, pollution of air, pollution of soil, water pollution, then noise pollution, these, as we are facing ourselves, could be the cause of pollution of our environment. So in this chapter, as we have discussed earlier, that we are facing now two of the major problems, and these are disposal of wastes and other is depletion of ozone layer. So first of all, we will talk about disposal of waste. As we know, anything that is no longer useful for us is called waste, or the thing that is discarded as it is, it has served its purpose and now it is not useful for us, is waste. So the waste that we generate, as we know, it include the different types of waste. These are solid waste, liquid waste, and gaseous waste. Solid waste, as we see, like farm waste, waste from kitchens, then plant residue, then animal dung, etc. These are the solid waste. Then beside that, human excreta, this also comes under solid waste. Then liquid waste, these are like sewage water, then waste from industries, etc. Then gaseous waste like automobile exhausts, then smoke from chimneys of industries or houses, etc. So these are the types of waste. Now we will talk about the solid waste. Solid waste, as we see, these are gets accumulated in the environment for shorter or longer period or duration, and when they accumulate, these waste makes the surrounding dirty and also pollute the soil. Beside that, they block the flow of drains and spread many types of diseases, because it the waste that is there, it became the breeding ground for many types of insects, flies, rats, mosquitoes, and they spread many types of diseases. As we know earlier, when the population, human population, was low, the solid wastes were easily degraded or decomposed by the decomposers that were present in nature, and they did not create much harm to the environment. But as we are seeing that in recent year, population has grown up to a greater extent. So now decomposers are not able to decompose all the solid waste that are generated by the increasing population. Beside that, technology has also changed. As we know, technology have also become greatly advanced, and due to this, improvement in life style has taken place. For example, now we are using more and more disposable substances, like disposable plastic or paper cups in trains, and disposable materials and in parties and marriages, etc. And if these substances are made up of biodegradable substances or biodegradable material, then it is then they are not creating much harm to our environment, or we can say we are environment friendly. But if these are made up of plastic and other material that cannot be degraded easily, or non-biodegradable substances, so then they can give much harm to the environment. If biodegradable substances are there, we are eco-friendly. But if non-biodegradable substances are there, then we have to search for new methods to control the pollution caused by the garbage that we produce. So there are many ways of reducing the pollution. These could be recycling of certain materials like plastic, and plastic material we can send to the respective recycling units. Beside that, paper, if we have much of the waste that are having paper material, this paper or discarded paper can be sent to the paper mills for recycling. Then metals that also are there in our wastes, they can also be sent to the industries for recycling. Beside that, plastic or polythene that is making a greater part of our waste can be used for making of roads, etc., mixing with asphalt. So it is done in some of the states. Roads are made by using this polythene material. Second method we can use is landfill. The waste that we generate, if it is in solid form, it can be buried in low lying areas, and these landfills can make the place at height. After that, compost can also be made by using these wastes. Beside that, the chemical waste or the waste from the hospitals, etc., can be burnt to the greater temperature, up to the temperature up to the 1000 degree Celsius, and they can be converted into directly into ash, and that ash can be used as landfills. So this chemical wastes or the hospital waste, this is done in closed circuits or closed room like structures in which there is a space for putting the waste, and it can be burnt up to the higher temperature. The temperature is so high that the material is directly converted into ash, and a huge amount of material can be converted into a small amount of ash. Beside that, the gases that are produced, they are directly sent through the pipes to the upper environment. So these are the ways by which we can decrease the amount of waste material that we produce. So in book, in NCERT book, there are given activities 15.7, then 15.8, 15.9 and 15.10. These are based on these activity, these how we can decrease the pollution that we are creating. So methods can be done by using these activities. You all have to do all these activities on in your notebooks yourself, and then one someday I will discuss the answer of these activities. So that's all for today. Tomorrow or on the next turn, we will talk about the ozone layer and how it is getting polluted, getting depleted. So that's all for today. Thank you.